Because we have a role to play in informing development processes. I thank you. Hamilton, please.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone. Our chief guests and all participants. In front of you here, we are looking at how we can increase the production and productivity of coffee in southwestern Uganda. And this is coming from the problem that we are confronted with. That is the issue of low seedling survival rate of the coffee, seedling that is being provided by government, and other challenges. So when you look at this, we try to look into why the low seedling survival rate. And I will start looking at what we found out that they are poor quality seedlings. And this is coming because we do not have clear source of coffee seed for the nursery bed operators. And in that case, also when the nursery operators raise the seedlings, they are supplied late to farmers. And also the nursery bed operators produce more seedlings, and yet the demand is very low. So they overkeep these seedlings in their nurseries, and then they lose the vigor and growth to survive on the new plantation when they are taken back, taken by the farmers. And this is also coming because of the delayed instruction to supply seedlings. These are coming from, I would say, the nursery bed operators. And also, the farmers themselves are not transporting the seedlings well. As they carry them, they don't want to carry bulk because the vehicle is faster squeezed. They want to remove the potting materials, and in the end, the soil that is keeping the plant moist to help it go and survive for some time. So by the time the seedlings are reaching the farmers, they are ready without soil. And also when they are transporting them, as I say, they are overseas. They hit them on each other, that one causes congestion, and then some of them get stretched up and they are destroyed. There is delay and inadequate payment of services offered by coffee nursery bed operators. I think the institutions that pay them take them too long. Take them too long to pay them. And at the same time, these nursery bed operators do not have the ability to assess the quality of seeds that they are given. So for them, they only receive from what the person who supplies them gives them. They do not understand it. They just plant them. Besides all this, they're saying that it's unpredictable weather patterns. As the presenter on environment and natural resources said, we are faced with the challenge of climate change. And this is dawning on us. So even if you have the seedlings, it will not survive because of no rain. There's inadequate logistical support for essential workers who are there. But this is coming because the few that are there, they are not also supported well. But the key thing is there are no extension workers. If they are there, the very few are overwhelmed. What we found out in every sub-county is having one extension worker, and these extension workers are not qualified in all the aspects of production. Our second problem that we are looking at the low coffee yield. We look at low coffee yield for unit area. The survival rate may be another issue of planting new ones, but also we have the issue of yield. Farmers are not being guided for proper coffee management because of the extension I've just mentioned, so they do not know how to go about with it well. The issue of farmers not realizing income value of coffee as a business for them, a main source of income. And my colleague will come and confirm this. So they don't take it as a serious enterprise. Why it's coming? Because they do not understand the mathematics of what cost and what benefit comes out of this COVID. Why should they go for it? And now they have shifted to other crops like bananas and what, and yet coffee still has higher value. So besides this also, as our earlier presenter said, there is loss of soil fertility. Ugandan soils have lost everywhere, have lost fertility. But also, we are saying they have lost fertility. The little that is there, we do not know what kind of nutrients are lost. We do not know, including myself, the coffee farmer or the extension worker, because we do not have the soil analysis map that can guide the extension worker to advise farmers adequately on what to, what manure or what fertilizer to add. And this is kind of because we have not updated maybe our data, the soil data analysis. And last, the key thing that we found that is affecting our operations or working well with farmers, that they have lost trust in institutions that are working with them. And the institutions are very many. I think we know them who is working with farmers. So when we look at that problem, I want us to look at the issue of supplying the seedling to the farmer that's leading to the low survival rate, and the aspect of the practices that the farmers do with the extension workers to improve both the survival and the productivity of this coffee. So these are the partners, and our approach here has to be very clear. Three things kill. If there are three things, then we don't care about them. So our focus is the inputs, not for free. The evidence will come that you know that farmers don't want your free thing. They may not want it. So we are saying here at the regulatory level and the policy implementation, we are having National Agricultural Advisory Service, Coffee Development Authority, that are supposed to guide the process. The Coffee Development Authority is supposed to work with what we are calling sub-county coffee extension workers. These are coffee specific, because if you don't give it attention, this current extension worker who is in livestock, in fisheries, food and nutrition will not handle it well. So we need a specific extension worker for it. This extension worker will work with input dealers, not just siblings. He's supposed to work with the person who supplies all the other inputs for farmers. And the end, the farmers will get this thing through the input supplier. Everything will come through the input supplier. But what we are bringing in here, critically, is the role of where is the funding coming from. Evidence will tell us. The evidence now will tell us why we are bringing in private credit service providers. Private service credit providers that are a microfinance institution. This country, I think we all know there are very many microfinance institutions, including the formal and the informal. So we are suggesting that all the support for farmers' inputs must go through the microfinance support by financing it, and they will finance it to direct the input dealers to shorten the chain. So let the microfinance institution, whether it be SACO or microfinance support center, it must be from there to the input dealer directly. Then the farmer gets it for there. But the issue of certification, quality assurance, we are looking at the input quality regulator and UCDA. Then besides this, another key thing we are bringing in is the insurance. This insurance we are bringing in to mitigate the negative impact of the climate change. You have just heard that the La Nina issue of having intermittent rain or long drought is a key thing, and that's what is destroying our farmers. And for our coffee farmers to survive, we need them to be sheltered against this through insurance. And this is typically crop insurance that can help when they lose, they are compensated. So so that the sustainability of the movement continues. Besides that, there is a mission that we have introduced that will help oversee these operations at the sub-county level. We are calling them sub-county coffee development committee, and they comprise the parishes, and I hope here we have the parishes, the farmers themselves, and the civil society, where these farmers are, so that they can have a voice. In terms of the quality issue, quantity, that's what will happen at the sub-county. And the university is coming in to provide what we are calling an evidence-based improvement throughout the process in terms of research and training. So the university